Whoa, look at this. 260Z. Oh my God, dude. I think it might let me in to take a closer look. How's it going, Bub? I was just walking by.
You want to take a closer picture?
Sure. This is a classic right here. Oh, it feels good in here. Nice and cool. Hey, puppy.
It stays cool till about July, August. It stays pretty
This
cool.
is nice.
A little dusty right now, but.
That's all right. I did see like 20 or 30 of the 280Zs all tore up. They were parked out in some rusting out up there in Oregon. I made a video and then somebody saw the video and says, "Oh man, where is this place? I want to buy one."
Rusty, go.
What year is it?
74, they're a 1 year only, the
Oh, the
transition
260?
between the 240 and 280.
Right.
This car was done back in the early 90s, and when it was finished, first done, it was perfect. It didn't have that big delamination right there.
Sure.
And there's another one here. There's a couple bad spots in the paint where the roof, you know, when
Well,
they
they get
painted
old.
it. But, you know, for
This is a
being
very
a,
rare car then.
got this emblem here. This car actually has a later model 285 speed in it instead of the 4-speed. And we also put the rear end in it out of that 5-speed to make it the right ratio to work with
Right,
it for
right.
the engine. And did urethane bushings and stuff and different struts. And it's a buddy of mine. It belonged to him, Joel Sosi. He's from here. And we were both young kids back then and working in an exhaust shop that another buddy ran. So we put the roll cage in it. And I know that in 2000, when Garmin e-trexes first came out, I bought one at a pawn shop. And they were pretty accurate speed, you know. So we took this car out on Highway 26 going to a party in Pullman to go see some friends. And his speedo was saying like 140, 150 mile an hour or something. I go, no way it's that fast. It ain't that fast. I knew it wasn't that fast. And I'm in the passenger seat and I got this Garmin e-trex. And
What did you say?
we got up to 124.9 miles an hour. And it wouldn't go to 125. It was and then it'd go down a few, you know, 123, 124. And then he just had it pinned, just totally pinned it. And we came up over a little hump and got a little bit of down there. And we hit 125 miles an hour. And there were no seat belts in the car.
Right,
There were no seat belts.
74.
There's still no seat belts in it. It's
Roll
supposed to.
cage, okay.
Yeah.
At that
It's
speed, was it?
tight.
Was it a tight? Was it
Yeah, it's
shaking
tight.
like?
It didn't
Okay.
start lifting the rear. I
Cool.
think that little old wing on there gave it just enough downforce without too much. It doesn't have much down. It's kind of, but I'm sure when they designed it, they probably made it so it had a little bit of push down. Plus, the whole nose and
Keeps
slope
it
of this
squatted
car,
down, yeah.
it naturally wants to push into the wind anyway. It's not a lift kind of car.
Sure,
And then
sure.
with this lip on the front of it, that probably cut a lot from going underneath it and making it lift, you know.
Very
But
nice.
125 in a car like this was cool. It's got a cammed up motor and a high compression motor. He always wanted to put three side draft Webers on it here. But back then it was like 1500. Now you're looking at 3 grand to do that now here.
Sure.
So it's got the stock Solex, you know, oil filled carbs on it, but it runs hard and strong. It's got a good torque cam, a little thump to it. It's all real dirty now, shucks. Doesn't even look pretty.